Welcome to my fifth tutorial on signals and systems. In this video, I will discuss one problem from grade 2021 ECE. And you see, the problem is related to a discrete sequence and its DTFT, discrete time Fourier transform. Now, you look at the problem closely. One sequence x of n given and y of n, another sequence is also given. Then their corresponding discrete time Fourier transform, capital X of e to the power j omega and capital Y of e to the power j omega. Okay. Now we need to compute this one, this integral. 1 upon 2 pi, 0 to 2 pi, this integral, capital X of e to the power j omega times capital Y of e to the power minus j omega d omega. So how to compute this one, right? Now, to solve this problem, we can use Parseval's identity or Parseval's relation. We can use it, right? So that is generalized Parseval's relation is there. So first I'll state that one. So if you have a sequence xn and its corresponding DTFT, is capital X of e to the power j omega, right? And yn is another sequence, and its DTFT is capital Y of e to the power j omega. Then the Parseval's identity or relation is that we can consider summation x of n and y star n. Right, so we can take summation for entire range minus infinity, and here we'll consider that the xn and yn both are energy signal. So these are energy signal. Okay, that we are assuming. If it is possible, then also we can compute, but that is different cases. Now here you see this sequence is converging, both the sequences are converging in one direction, so it will have finite energy. Okay, so these are energy sequences. Now this summation is same as 1 upon 2 pi and over 2 pi integral. Okay, because DTFT is periodic over 2 pi. Right, so it's suppose capital X of e to the power j omega and y star e to the power j omega and d omega. Right, so here you can notice one thing, that this one will be, so this 1 minute. So you see here that this xn and yn both are given, okay, and corresponding this one is also given. And if you look at these sequences, and obviously these two sequences are real sequence, okay. So if xn and yn both are real sequence, especially this yn, okay, if we consider yn is a real sequence, then its Fourier transform capital Y star e to the power j omega, that we can show that it is same as capital Y of e to the power minus j omega, right? And again, this S is real, so Y star n is same as Y n. So these two we can use for real sequence. So if it is real sequence, so here it is given clearly, it's a real sequence. Okay. So what we can do? We can simplify this thing as simply x n and y n. That multiplication, that summation. Okay, that will be same as 1 over 2 pi integration for 2 pi, the simple x of e to the power j omega, and this is capital Y of e to the power minus j omega and d omega, right? And you see that is given here. So 1 over 2 pi 0 to 2 pi x of j omega and y of e to the power minus j omega d omega. So this is same as this summation of xn times simply yn, and n is from minus infinity to plus infinity. So we need to compute only this one. Okay, and that we can do easily. Okay, so you see. So what is xn given? So xn is given as 2 to the power n minus 1 and u of minus n plus 2. And yn is given as 2 to the power minus n plus 2 and u of n plus 1, right? Now, first we'll try to draw these two sequences, right? So we'll consider this axis. Now this axis, this is your n. This is 0. This is 1. This is 2, 3, 4. This is minus 1. Minus 2, minus 3, minus 4, like that. Okay, all are there. Now, first we will draw this x of n. Okay, and that we will draw with this blue color. Right, so you see here, this is u of minus n plus 2. So this value is positive. So minus n plus 2 is positive when n is less than 2, right? Or equal sign I can put it. That means when n is less than equal to 2, this xn will exist, and right side it is 0. So when n is more than 2, it is 0. Okay, so we'll start with n equal to 2. At n equal to 2, x of n. So 2 to the power 2 minus 1. So you see here n equal to 2, I'll put. So 2 to the power 2 minus 1 is 2 to the power 1, means 2 only. Okay, so this value is 1, always. Okay, so it is 2. So at n equal to 2, it is 2. I'll draw in that way. Okay, so this value is 2. I'll put the value as well, right? Then n equal to 1, this is always 1 because minus 1 plus 1 is 1, and it is 1 minus 1 is 0, 2 to the power 0 is 1, so its value is half of that, it's 1. Okay, and then this one, n equal to 0, its value is 2 to the power 0 minus 1, means 2 to the power minus 1 is half. Okay, so this value is becoming again half of that. So this is half. Then n equals to minus 1, 2 to the power minus 2, that means 1/4. Then it will be 1/8, like that. So you see, this is exponentially decaying one, or this is going toward this side, starting from this side. Okay, this range it is existing. Now, if I want to draw this y of n, so this is your x of n. I want to draw the similar axis here. So this is 0, this is 1, this is 2, this is 3, this is 4, this side is minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4, like that, okay? So here you see, I'll consider this one. So this is positive, n plus 1 is more than 0. It implies that n is more than equal to minus 1. So when n is less than minus 1, then it is 0. Okay, y of n is 0. So minus 1. So I'll start with n equal to minus 1. Because this side it is zeros. Right? So n equal to minus 1, its values. So minus minus is plus. So it is 2 to the power 1 plus 2 is 3, 2 to the power 3. 2 to the power 3 is 8. So at minus 1, it is 8. So this value is 8. Right? And then it is divided. So it's all time is power of 2 to the power minus n. So half of that one. Okay? So next time it will be half of that one. The 4. Then again half of that one is 2, then again half of that one is 1, then there half of that one is half, like that. Right? Now we need to compute this one, the summation over for xn and yn. So this product, n equal to minus infinity to plus infinity. Now, you see xn is going towards negative side and yn is going towards right side. So there is certain overlap. And overlap is between minus 1 to plus 2. That's all. Okay. So within that only we will compute. So that means x of minus 1 and y of minus 1 plus x of 0, y of 0, plus x of 1, y of 1, plus x of 2 and y of 2. And rest all are zeros. Either, so when x is more than this one, 2, that time it is 0, x of 3, x of 4, it's zeros. That's how this right side zeros. And the left side, y of minus 2, minus 3, all are zeros, that it is zeros. Okay, so this value, now we can put it. So this is your 1 by 8, sorry, this is half, and this is 1 by 8, okay? So I write it, this is half, and this one is 8. And then corresponding is, half, or it's 1 by 4, it was, no? It was 1 by 4. At this one, it is 1 by 4. At 0, it is half. This is half times, and at 0 it is 4, so it is 4 plus. And then at 1, this is 1 and this is 2, so 1 cross 2 plus. At 2 it is 2 and this is 1, so 2 cross 1. So you see, so this is 2, this is also 2. This is 2, this is 2. So 2 plus 2 plus 2. Okay. So all are 2. So total is 2 into 4 is 8. So answer is simply 8. Right? So our answer is 8. That we have got already. Right? Now I want to prove that one, this generalized Parseval relation or identity. So it's interesting. So just a few minutes I can take. So what we'll do, I want to prove this one. Xn and y star n, this summation n is minus infinity to infinity, the same as 1 upon 2 pi, and it is over 2 pi range, capital X of e to the power j omega, and y star e to the power j omega and d omega. So let us prove that one first, okay? So what is the proof? So we can start with this thing that inverse DTFT. So yn, we can write 1 upon 2 pi integration capital X of, sorry, capital Y of e to the power j omega e to the power j omega n, and it is d omega. It's what, 2 pi, right? Now if I take conjugate on both sides, so what you will get? This is y star n, star is conjugate, okay? I'm assuming that y would be complex. This is 1 upon 2 pi, is this real quantity only? It is what, 2 pi is fine. And now this y could be complex, so its star is complex, e to the power j omega. And this is already it's a complex form, and conjugate of this one is e to the power j theta. Conjugate is e to the power minus j theta. So it is e to the power minus j omega n, and it is d omega. Now multiply both sides by xn, then what will get? So this is xn and y star n. So I can write this 1 over 2 pi, the summation, the integration 2 pi, this is your y star, e to the power j omega. So here I can put xn, no harm at all. So anywhere I can put it, and e to the power minus j omega n and d omega. Now I'll take summation on both sides, okay, over n is minus infinity to infinity, n minus infinity to infinity. Now this one here, this is one xn function of n, this one function of n, and that I can do first, summation I can do first, and then I'll go for this integration. Okay, interchange the summation and integration together, okay. So what you'll do, so 1 upon 2 pi is outside, the integration over 2 pi is fine, and this is y star e to the power j omega, then summation, the summation x of n e to the power minus j omega n, this one, and then d omega was here, and this n summation is minus infinity to infinity. Look and notice this one, that this summation summation over x n e to the power minus j omega n, that is same as capital X of e to j omega, because capital X of e to the power j omega is same as summation x n dt of t e to the power minus j omega n, n is minus infinity to infinity. So can I replace this one by simply capital X of e to the power j omega? So if you replace, just see this summation, you will get same as 1 over 2 pi y star to j omega, and this one, exactly this one. Okay, so we'll get this. This is summation x n and y star n is 1 over 2 pi over 2 pi integral capital X of e to the power j omega and y star e to the power j omega and d omega. And the summation is n minus infinity to infinity. And for real sequence, if yn is real, then what we can do? Okay. So already, so you know that yn, so we can go for these things. Okay. Y of e to the power j omega, the Fourier transform, we can write that it is x, this is your yn times e to the power minus j omega n equals to minus infinity to infinity. Now take conjugate on both sides. Okay, so what you will get? So this is y star e to the power j omega. And right side, simply it is y star, small y star n. And this conjugate is positive, e to the power j omega n, and n is minus infinity to infinity. Now, this y star n is a real, yn is a real, so y star n is same as yn. So can I replace this thing as yn? And e to the power j omega n equals to minus infinity to infinity. Now what is this? So this is similar to this one. Only changes is here it is positive w, here it is minus w. So if I replace both sides by minus w, w by minus w, then we will get this result. So this one I can say that it is same as y, capital Y e to the power minus j omega. Okay, for positive, for real yn. Now again, so what we are getting, this y star of e to the power j omega is capital Y of e to the power minus j omega. Now interchange this, means again replace w by minus w. What you will get? You will get y star of e to the power, okay, it's not required. So this is only the thing that we have got it. So y star of e to the power j omega is y of e to the power j omega. So you see this one I can write as 1 over 2 pi, this 2 pi, right? And this is your x of e to the power j omega. And this y star of e to the power j omega I can replace by this one. This is y of e to the power minus j omega. And this is d omega. And that is same as, this is xn. And y star is again yn, because real. So n is minus infinity. So this is for real. Real yn. Is right? So it's proved. I hope you have got the concept. So I'll be uploading more problems in my channel. So please keep on watching my videos, and if you like, please subscribe. my channel. Thank you.